you better get your towels ready, cause it's about to go down. Ha ha ha, I know. Everybody keep on your toes, cause I'm running this thing. I'm on a boot. I'm on a boot. Everybody look at me, cause I'm sailing on a boot. I'm on a boot. I'm on a boot. Take a good hard look at the... Oh, okay now, boot. I'm on a boot, everybody. Look at me. Straight sailing on a boot in the deep blue sea. 5-knot winds whipping out my coat. You can't stop me, everybody, cause I'm on a boot. I probably should have learned the rest of the lyrics here. But, in other words, I'm just gonna keep going like this instead. Oh, I remember this verse, though. Don't worry about it. I'm on a boot, and I got all sorts of other things going on, and it's gonna be real fun when we do that. You know what I mean? I'm just really trying to... Okay, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Not on a boot. I know you were worried, but I did bring my nautical-themed Pashmina Afghan. Any fans of the show know I'm a sucker for Pashmina. Anyway, so glad you guys are here. Welcome back to Quarantine with Kenny. I am your host from coast to coast to coast to coast, Mr. Kenny Swimmy Foster. And I am so glad that you guys are here. We have got a really fun... We've got... I don't know if you saw my promo from earlier, but we have a two-for-one special today. Two great artists at the exact same time on this Thursday. I'm in a great mood. I'm not going to lie. It's been a great week. We got pre-production on the new record. It is rolling. It is in full swing. And we go in with the boys next week. So I'm super excited. I will miss you all next week. But right now, we need to focus, Kenny, on the task at hand, which is to bring in two fantastic artists for the price of one. Let me tell you a little bit about each of them. She, ladies and gentlemen, they are both from the UK. Wonderful people, dear friends. Can't wait to talk to them and see their faces, even if virtually for just a short time. So they are both from the UK. She is a UK-based songwriter and artist who has been gaining momentum and endorsements from Whisperin' Bob, Chris Difford, Under the Apple Tree, The House of Songs, and Americana Music Association. She had a successful debut EP, Tracks and Trails, and the follow-up Dandelion EP that were on 1 and 2, respectively, on the UK country charts. That's a great deal, and I'm jealous. What can I say? So she has a single, Because of Her, that she released on July 31st, and her debut album, The Things We Didn't Say. I'm excited. Tell me more about it. I can't wait. He, Robbie Cavanna, self-confessed devotee. I love this. I just like the way he speaks. Self-confessed devotee of real music. Real music, ladies and gentlemen. Not fake stuff. He's going for the jugular on that. He has an album, To Leave and To Be Left, received massive critical acclaim. He's Under the Apple Tree. He has been very supportive of his music. He supported The Wandering Hearts, Beth Nielsen Chapman, Robert Vincent, among others. He has a single, Feeding Your Time, released August 17th, 2020. I don't know if you guys have heard this. You should get it into your eardrums because it's important. And he is in production right now for his next record. Samesies, man. Samesies. We got to talk about this process because it's absolutely crazy. So anyway, both of them have played a ton of amazing shows all over the UK, a bunch of festivals and beyond. And I hope that you guys are ready to meet them because I can't wait to bring them in. Any warm round of applause to Demi Mariner and Robbie Cavanna. Guys! Do-do-do-do-do! I was on a boot, and you guys are in a forest / jungle. I'm very excited about that for you and from you. Guys, how are you? Catch me up.
How are you?
Oh, my gosh. I don't know. How are any of us? That's why I ask. That's why I open with that question, because it's just, it's weird, and it's fine, and sometimes it's terrible, and sometimes it's just great. So I'm on the uptick right now, you know, but whenever you're working on music, it makes everything a little bit easier. Catch me up, you guys. I need to hear everything. Start in March when everything got canceled and we were all very sad, and take me up to now. Go.
Well, I just finished a tour, like a couple of days prior to lockdown, I finished a tour, and then I remember Demi and my tour manager at the same time were all getting phone calls cancelling everything else for the foreseeable future.
Yes.
So really, I felt very lucky to finish that, but it was a really weird moment where I think you always hear rumours of these illnesses and things, and they never really amount to much. And for suddenly this was like a really serious thing, it became clear, didn't it?
I think we like looked back on the last couple of dates of the tour and we're kind of like, there was a lot of people crammed into tiny rooms. That feels
I know, like, man.
Hindsight.
I know. We were in Berlin. I think that was like the last big event to happen in Germany at that time for C2C, like right then. And I was stuck in London when they put the travel ban on for the USers. So that was exciting. As everything went. You're like, well, I'm going to keep my regular flight. Hopefully they honor it. Question mark. I don't know. It was fine. Obviously I made it. So what have you guys been doing to cope? I mean, music is gone. I know you guys had a string. You were doing insane amounts of things during quarantine, covering other people's tunes. It was really lovely. Tell everybody about that.
Yeah, so I think when it first kind of started, we both knew that we needed some sort of like outlet project. Otherwise, I'd probably just have stayed in my pajamas all day. So I was like, I need a reason to do something with myself. So yeah, we did a project that we called Artist of the Day, where we covered an artist's song every single day and put a video up. And yeah, it was just kind of a way, it was an outlet for us, but also a lot of musicians and our friends were all struggling. So we just wanted to kind of be able to do something to help everybody out and keep everyone's sort of name floating around and music floating around. So that was really fun. It was a fun project.
What was that process like for you guys? Like, I mean, how did you decide? And then like, how long did it take to work up covers?
It was. I think it actually was quite a lot more difficult than I'd anticipated. I think we were selecting artists that we knew personally and we knew the songs pretty well, so it was a pretty smooth process. But then the more we got into it, like, and we were doing these daily. This every day we had to learn a song, figure out. Often we were trying to do like an alternative arrangement of it, so we were arranging it. Then we had to record and film it. And then we had to upload it, and then we started kind of editing them in a really cool way as well. So it ended up being like a whole day thing. And that was kind of one of the reasons that we stopped doing it, because the reason for doing it was to have this routine and a bit of enthusiasm about something. And it did get to a point where we were like, okay, maybe we need to do less of these.
Sure.
Actually do something else with our time as well.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm sure it was a great distraction, as much as I'm sure everybody, including myself, I'm very appreciative of all of the work that you did on it, because it was very, very apparent. Thank you guys for doing that. So what, besides the music stuff, like, are you finding, were you binge watching stuff? Did you guys, once you found time after that whole series, like what have been your guilty pleasures? How have you passed the time that maybe you're a little embarrassed to say? What's it about?
I think these guys are a big part of it.
Gardening.
We started looking after our plants a lot.
Which is impossible for musicians.
Yeah, like serious like plant people. It's ridiculous. It's like a whole thing to it. But yeah, I think a lot of plants. We've watched a lot of Netflix shows and three-part dramas. Tons of dramas.
Yeah. A lot of Australian stuff. I think Australia seemed to get over COVID quicker than everyone else and just get back to it. So
yeah,
they released a whole bunch of Australian reality TV shows and all this stuff we couldn't get to the UK. So I've just been watching Australian shows for the last, I think.
And a lot That's of amazing. Shows, Robbie watches a lot of those like barbecue cook-off Netflix shows and stuff like that that he's really into.
Yeah.
I love, are you picking up Trips and Ticks and Trips?
I'm trying. I mean, I do enjoy cooking, but yeah. I think until you've got a real smokehouse kind of thing, I don't think that barbecued meats is going to be my forte. But
Man, next time I'm over, I will give you the shortened version where you don't need an entire smokehouse, and we're gonna get you some meat. I might know a few things. I grew up in barbecue country, son. I know what's going on about all that. That's super exciting. I'll tell you, my wife and I, Sarah, who you know, of course, we got into a UK show, actually, which is called Staffless Flats.
I don't even think I know what that is.
Oh my gosh. It's on HBO Max right now, but like Staffless Flats, it's absurd. It's about like a Greek family that run an apartment letting service.
and I'm writing this down already.
And it's like a almost mockumentary, but it's not like breaking the fourth wall with The Office, but it's the same sort of like silent, awkward. It's so good.
Yeah, I've seen a few photos of this.
I'm telling you, there's only like 8 episodes out right now, but please check that out because Sarah and I lost our minds about it, and I apologize in advance. And also, you're welcome. So let's talk about we had some fan questions. People rang in. I'm gonna hit you. We'll alternate. Okay. So this first one goes to Demi here. It says, "Tell us when we get to hear the things we didn't say." What I know, everything had to get pushed off. Is that an indefinite thing that's happening, or is it coming to a theater near you?
To a theater near you. Well, yeah, it was supposed to come out this summer.
Of course.
Just wasn't the right time. Yeah.
Of course, I understand because we can't support the record with the tour, which especially as indies, we understand how vital / important.
100%. So I think the plan is that it will be out early next year, and. Great. Hopefully things will be back to normal and it can be sort of followed up with festival season and touring and we'll just be as it was supposed to be, but kind of a year later.
I get it. I can't wait to be on a bill with you guys again sometime soon.
I know. Really,
that was, do you know why I did the introduction today on a boot? Because we met on a boat. Anyway,
it's fine. I get it.
I play with layers, ladies and gentlemen. That's what I do. So, Ravi, you're in pre-production right now for your record. Tell me about it. Like, where are you at in the process? You'll probably release, I'm sure, similarly around Demi, so you guys get this tour thing going, but tell me about it.
Yeah, well, I think I have a bunch of songs. I always say that to try and find the sweet spot, because I think at first you love all your songs, and
sure.
Then you have too many to put on an album. But then I think over time, naturally, like, you start to eliminate songs that you realize aren't really good enough to go on. But then if you wait too long, you hate them all, and you don't have an album anymore. So, I think we're very close to the sweet spot where I like enough to make an album of. I've just been kind of sending those demos to the band so they can get a bit of a feel for it. And then we're going to the studio in January.
Great.
So we'll be going in and just recording it live and seeing what happens. I'm excited about it.
Great, man. Well, I'm excited. I can't wait to hear new music from both of y'all when you let it happen. I might ask for an advance copy. I don't want to like pull rank here or anything. I'm not trying to like get insider info, but I might. So the question is for you two. Have you been to Germany at this point? This is for both of you.
I haven't. I'm sorry.
But Robbie has.
I've played a couple of shows in Germany, in Hamburg and Berlin.
Fantastic, man. Well, we need to get both of you over there soon because I know we've got viewership that needs to get what y'all do into their ear holes.
Yeah.
So here's one for Demi, and then we'll go back to Robbie, and then we're going to move this show right along, ladies and gentlemen. Demi, who is your dream co-write?
Ooh. That was weird. Present
company excluded. It's fine. I understand.
Oh, that's such a tough question.
Mm-hmm.
I think, I mean, this is probably always my answer. I think it would be Laurie McKenna. Mainly because I think she's brilliant.
She's tops.
She really is.
She's brill.
She's great. Right. So, my dream, yeah.
Okay. I've got it. I'm making a note. Laurie McKenna. Okay. Robbie, here's yours. What's your favorite tour memory?
Tour memory.
It'll be food related.
Man, after my own heart.
I feel like I haven't discovered enough food on tour. I feel like you have to go with the majority vote, and I think you end up just finding a place that's nearby and serves a bit of everything. So you never actually get to explore the way that I'd like to. But I think we have a game that we always play, which is called, what's he scratching now? So basically what happens is...
You really sold that name, by the way. Like, I'm intrigued just by the delivery. Okay, keep going. Go.
So basically, is that after the show, everyone's had a few drinks and gone to bed, and it works better if everyone's in this, if you're in like one big room. And the lights go out, and someone has to itch a part of their body, and from sound alone, you have to figure out what part they're itching. So every time that game is played is my favorite tour memory.
That's the most absurd thing I've ever heard. I don't.
Was that the
literally answer? Never heard of that ever, ever. And it's brilliant. It's brilliant. It's a much cleaner version of another game that I've heard about from Dane Cook. I won't get into it. Every week on the show, we highlight a charity of some sorts. And I know you guys have got a lot to say about this. So this week we're highlighting Help Musicians, which is in the UK specifically. It is a charity for professional musicians of all genres, starting out from when they're young and spry to when they're even into retirement age. So they're covering the whole span instead of just hitting you when you're on the rise, you're falling down, or just need some struggle. Like, I think it's really cool. They help at times of crisis, but also at times of opportunity, giving them extra support they need at critical points that could make or break their career. That's really, really cool. You guys wanted to highlight that. And currently they're working on an amazing fundraising project. Will you two tell us a little bit more about that?
Yeah. So, well, Help Musicians, firstly, at the beginning of all of this craziness and lockdown, they offered a bunch of funding to artists, independent artists that were struggling. And then thousands of pounds worth of grants given out in like £500 lump sums to artists just to basically help them survive, which was an amazing thing and like hugely helpful.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, so we're involved in a project that Whispering Bob from Radio 2, BBC Radio 2, has kind of organised. So it's celebrating 50 years of him in broadcasting and 60 years of his favourite song, Stand By Me. So he's got a whole bunch of artists get together to basically record a brand new version of that record, which is just insane. We're both obviously so honoured to have been asked to do that. And more honoured, I think, now that we know the incredible lineup on that. Because when we were asked, we were just like, oh, that's really lovely, thanks.
Sure, thanks. Yeah, thanks for thinking of us.
Yeah, like sent off some parts, and then a little while later we were with Miles, Bob's son, who is does all the Under the Apple Tree stuff.
Yep.
And he's mixing the track and playing a couple of the clips that he'd had back. And we were playing a bit of a guessing game because he was saying, oh, whose voice is this? And we knew it was a lot of British artists that we knew and friends, right. So we were kind of guessing. And then there were a couple of occasions where we were like, I can't think who this is. Like, I don't recognise the voice because I'm expecting it to be somebody I know. And
sure.
Like, oh, that's Kiki D. And we were like, oh.
Oh.
Well, okay then. Brilliant. So yeah, that's the project. And they're trying to raise £10,000 through like a crowdfunding thing that will all be donated to Help Musicians.
Great.
Super awesome and like a really cool little project to be involved in. But yeah, Help Musicians have just done a lot to help independent.
Absolutely. That's great. Thank you, guys. I love hearing the testimonials. So if you guys are at home and you are a musician that is in need of help, or if you would like to give to this great organization, please go check it out. We have links in the bio. You can also check out, is there a website they can check out?
For Help Musicians or for the...
Yeah. Helpmusicians.org?
Yeah.
.co.uk? I don't know. I'm just making things up. So Help Musicians is the thing. Okay, so guys, I know we didn't get to talk a lot before we set this up, so you are not adequately prepared, but we're about to play a game right now, okay? It's called Wheel of Filters! So what you need to do is you have to go to the happy face with the sparkles on your screen right there. You're going to click it, and it's going to give you just a big old scroll at the bottom of your screen of filters available on your phone. And I want you two to find a filter that fits your mood right now, and we're going to play a little game. All right? So just scan on through there. Take your time with it. I don't want you to worry about all of these things. I had a really kind of cool... Ooh, you had some sparkles there. Ooh, moody. It kind of looks like it turned your wall blue and it made it look like you guys were at the ocean. It was really kind of special, if I'm being honest.
See, the problem is Demi saves a lot of filters, so we have to get past a load of like genuinely quite cool ones before we get to anything that's going to entertain anyone.
Oh, to the goofy ones. Whoa! What is the music challenge? Tell me about it. How do you make it stop?
I don't know.
I bet you it doesn't stop, man. Some of those twirly ones just do not. I saw One Direction. I saw Spice Girls in there. Oh, wow.
What animal are you, really?
You are giraffes. I don't know if you knew that.
That's okay.
Brilliant.
It's already been decided.
Glorious.
Right. Here we go. I've got one right here. How do you like this one right here?
Nice. Yeah.
Brilliant.
I'm too legit to quit. I don't, oh, you had a dog licking you.
Oh, great.
Oh, my gosh. That's amazing.
I mean, be the...
is that Robbie or is that? Oh, my gosh. That's funny. Yes. You get some love too, Rob. You guys don't have your plants are your pets, right? Your plants are your pets at this point.
Exactly. Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. No real actual puppy.
No.
Okay, let's just stop right now. What Friends character would you guys choose that you say that you are? How about that? I like that.
What do you go first?
I'd like to think I don't know. They've all got the flaws, haven't they? Maybe I'd go for Ross.
Oh yeah, you're a Ross. Mm. Oh, that's really special that you would say that. Oh. My wife insists that I'm a Chandler.
I
was gonna pin you as a Chandler, honestly. Demi, what do you think? That's what I want to know.
I mean, I think really I'd like to just be Joey, but maybe I'm Phoebe.
You think you're Phoebe? Oh my gosh.
Maybe.
Okay, Robbie, who do you think she is? I want to know. Without causing bliss strife in your household.
Is it better for me to just agree with the whatever? I think maybe a Monica. I mean, you love tidying.
I do, yeah.
You get a bit manic about things.
Manic?
Yes. Like a bit stressed.
Well...
I knew this. I'm so sorry I did that to you, Robbie. I just knew as soon as I started. That's very Monica of her, though, isn't it? I mean, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. All right. Enough filters, enough Friends talk. Let's give the people what they came here to see. Because we got three songs, ladies and gentlemen, that are coming at you today. Who wants to go first? Do you guys want to go? Do you want me to go? I don't care.
Hey, maybe you should go, Kenny.
I'm going to go first. Okay. Because I don't get harmonies on my stuff, so that makes sense. It's
we could
like,
try, but I think it would be very...
It would be terrible. It would be terrible. Thank you. So as you guys know, when you are making a record, Robbie, you were saying earlier, you have all the songs and you hate them all and then you love them all and you're trying to figure out which ones go. I mean, I haven't put out a record in... It's going to be, by the time this one comes out, it's probably going to be 4 years. So I have a lot of songs to pick from. And this was a tune that did not make the record, but was always in contention. And I feel like it needs to have some love right now because it didn't make the cut. But it was a song that was on hold for Massive Artists for 18 months, which is part of why I wasn't going to cut it. But it if Holds, do you guys know about Holds in Nashville?
Yeah.
So if Holds were hand grenades, it'd be a big crater under my house, man. That's all I'm saying. She only ever take two drags, so she never had to kick the habit. She was LA like that. Seattle running through her veins. She can only ever sing when it's raining, breaking that coffee black. She's a puzzle with a missing piece, a script without a silver screen. I wish that I could be the thing she needs. Cause there's a gypsy on my mind, always searching far and wide, holding hers like trying to catch the breeze. Pensacola, Santa Fe, I'm just a stop along the way. She's everywhere but here with me, cause she's in love with being free. You're always going coast to coast, like she's running from her goals. Says she doesn't plan on dying. Barrios and uptown streets, looking for something that she just can't reach. I wonder if she'll ever find it. Cause there's a gypsy on my mind, always searching far and wide, holding hers like trying to catch a breeze. Pensacola and Santa Fe, I'm just a stop along the way. It's everywhere but here with me, cause she's in love with being free. Script without a silver screen, I wish that I could be that thing she needs. Cause there's a gypsy on my mind, always searching far and wide, and holding hers like trying to catch the breeze. New York City, Frisco Bay, I'm just a stop along the way. She's everywhere but here with me, cause she's in love. Honey, she's in love being free. Being free. Should pretend like that's wind at the end. It's like a, all the way across. All right, you two, you decide. You decide who goes next. Let's do songs.
Maybe I should go next because your song's a better like closer, isn't it? Yeah, let's do that.
Sure.
I love it. I love it.
So I figure I should probably play Feeding Time, as that's the song that that's the single. That's what's out at the minute.
Do it, please.
Similarly to you, my last album is just over 3 years old now. So anything else I was to play for you would either be old or unreleased, and seems like a good opportunity to play something that people can actually go and check out.
Love it.
This is Feeding Time. Demi, if you want to join in, feel free, but no pressure also.
Got it.
It's a quiet town at the best of times, but eerily so. Recently old, but the neighbors like it ain't. Then it stops again. I'm thinking, I'm hoping, I'm making plans to be out of here by four, if not before. There's a diary, and it's full of lines. I cross them out again with a ballpoint pen. Sure, the weather's fine, but it's feeding time. Government
I love your melodies, man. I think they're really, really cool. I love your chord choices. You're not just sticking to four. Really cool voicings there, man. Is this what people can expect on the new record? Is it this kind of style? Are we going old, or is it just a big variety? Tell me a little bit more.
It's a funny one, really. I think I've really been leaning towards a lot more of a kind of old soul kind of vibe for a lot of the tunes on the record. But there's definitely still that kind of old school country feel as well. Mm-hmm. So it's somewhere between the two. That's part of it, still kind of figuring out. I feel like I really want to commit to a sound with it rather than trying to make it too varied. So I'm kind of figuring out a sound that's going to work for the album in general.
Well, good. Well, I wish you good luck on the journey. And I just want to hear a soul country record from a Brit. That's just what I want in my life right now. Demi, please grace us with your beauty and your voice. I want to hear it.
Oh, I miss you.
likewise, kiddos. Man, it's been too long. I'm trying to think of when we actually saw each other last. Was it when we had the road rage accident or incident? Was that it?
It was, yeah. I think we tried to meet when you were in the UK, but I think it was a bit of a whistle stop thing, so we didn't. So I think road rage accident, maybe, 2018 was that? 2 years ago.
Jeez, guys. Well, for those of you that are listening at home, before Demi gets this, because we should end on her thing, not mine. We were driving. I was driving these fine lovely. You were going to the Opry that night, right?
Yeah,
I thought so. So we had a little co-write here, and I was driving them back. My old beater car that used to sit in my front driveway for, I don't know, forever. And we were driving, and it was packed. It was rush hour, and we drove past, and I squeezed in a space that was far too small. But I was like, I'm going to be fine. It'll be fine. And then I ended up touching mirrors with this lady. And our mirror went down, and she freaked out, man. She freaked out. She freaked out in a really big way. And like, you what?
She was following you for like 20 minutes.
We had no idea. And then she's doing like 9,000 miles an hour. And I was like, guys, you're about to meet an American. Can I, give me just a second. Let me show you. I need to pull off here for a moment. I pulled out, and I got out of the car, and this lady was just yelling at me just so hard. And we looked at her car, and her car was fine. And like she almost didn't know what to do. And I was like, hey, honey, I'm really sorry. And she was just like, oh, okay.
It was just the principle of it. She needed an apology. I've never seen a man turn into like a sorry puppy so quickly. Like, you had your tail between your legs and you walked towards her, like, no aggression whatsoever. And I don't think she knew how to deal with that. Like, she was ready for an argument.
Yeah.
And it just
She wanted a fight, and I was like, look, I know I'm in the wrong here, but also, like, there's really nothing wrong here. It was this strange, it was this strange moment where it was like, I don't know what's going on in your life today, hon, because it was like a Friday night, you know, and I was just like, this lady just needs a hug, and I can't give her a hug because I don't know her, and she's trying to, like, film me. Oh, it was so weird. What a weird thing that was. It was like, it was a moment I had trauma from for, like, several days, and then I was like, I think it's okay. I think people in the world generally just need a hug. So we need to give them a musical hug right now. Demi!
Yes?
Let's give us a musical hug.
Okay. I'll do my best. This song is called Sins. We'll play that one.
Love it.
But yeah, it sounds like this. Are you ready?
Demi Manderley!
ladies and gentlemen. So glad you guys are here. It was beautiful, honey. I love it. You're so freaking sassy, and I'm scared to death right now, but I still want to see your face. It's so good. Thank you guys for coming. Demi, what? So on this new record, tell me more about it. Can you whet my appetite a bit more when it does come out? Like, what do I need to know?
I'm hoping that it'll be like April sort of time next year.
Yeah. I'm not worried about timing. Just tell me more. Just drop little hints. This is your hype train. I'm chugging. Tell me what excites you about it.
I think I love the band that played on it. I love that we recorded it all live in this like old converted chapel, and I feel like you can really hear that. And I think it's got some beans, and I like that.
Yeah, some beans. It's got some beans. She's not talking about the cans, ladies and gentlemen. So good. So hey, that's all we have, ladies and gentlemen. This was super fun, and I'm so glad you guys are here. Thank you for coming. Everybody who's tuning in right now, we are here every Thursday. Around the same time. This is what we do. Noon Nashville, 6 UK, 7 Central Europe. And we have fantastic guests like Demi and like Robbie. Thank you guys for with me today. This was super awesome. And for everyone else who's tuning in, I did want to say a little thing. There's going to be an announcement coming from Sound of Nashville tomorrow. I'm not going to tell you what it is. I'm not going to give it away. I'm not going to give away the horse, but I think you're going to be very virtually excited about it. So, I don't know. Just stay tuned to the socials. But if you want to keep up with these people, Robbie, you are past the manual. Am I correct?
Correct, yes.
Follow past the manual for this guy right here. And for this young lady, Demi Mariner Music?
D Mariner Music, but yeah, very close.
D Mariner Music.
Yeah.
But you should see that on your screen anyway, because that's who called in. Robbie, what were you doing? Slacking. That's what's happening. So these two, go follow these two. I am Kenny Foster Music, and I thank you guys so much for being here. You two, please take care of yourselves, and I can't wait to see you soon.
You too. Thanks for having us.
See you soon.
Of course, y'all. No. Oh, I almost forgot. Sarah just yelled at me. You need to leave us with a joke. Who is telling me the joke?
This is on you.
Well, I do know this one.
Yes.
So have you ever heard the story of the man with the big round orange head?
I don't think so.
Okay, so the guy goes into a bar, as any good joke starts with, and he spots on the other, just sat on the other end of the bar, is this guy with this huge, big, round, orange head, and he asks the bartender for a drink. Says, "I have a pint of beer." And also, what's going on with that guy with the big orange head? And he's like, "Oh, he's really lovely. Like, get him a beer, go and sit with him. He'll tell you all about it." She's great. Okay, so two beers then, and he takes it over and he says, "The bartender said if I got you a beer, you might tell me the story of your big, round, orange head." And he says, "Yeah, sure, take a seat, sit down." So he starts talking and he says, "Well, it all started a few years ago when I was walking down the lane and I came across this lamp. And I don't believe in genies. Genies aren't real, but I figured, you know, why take the risk? So
curiosity.
I figured, let's rub it and see what happens. And lo and behold, this genie bursts out of the lamp. And I couldn't believe my eyes. I still didn't really believe it. And he said, "You've got 3 wishes." And I thought, great, okay, well, I want all the riches in the land. And he said, "Done." And suddenly my pockets were full. There was more money than I could carry. My bank accounts were rocketing. It was amazing. And then he said, "Okay, what's your second wish?" And he said, "I want to marry the most beautiful woman in the land." And he said, "Done." And the most beautiful woman walked out of the ocean and came and stood near him. And the genie married them right away. It was unbelievable.
Beautiful.
And they said, "Okay, what about your third wish?" And I think this is where I went wrong. I asked for a big orange head. Thanks, guys.
Dude,
I don't know if you saw my face, but I remembered this joke when you got to the marriage thing, and I was just like, I can't wait for this punchline. It's so good. Your delivery was impeccable. I expected no less from you, my friend. And of course, you picked a story joke. No one-liners from this guy, and I appreciate that so much. You too. Love you guys. Be good. I will think about that joke for the next 2 weeks, and we will see you. Best of luck in all your endeavors. Stay happy, stay true, and if you need a smile or a pick me up, you call me, and we'll take care of it. All right.
Perfect.
Same to you, man.
Hugs and kisses. Bye. See you guys.